Hello, Chicers, and welcome back to Nerdy Chic Universe. And I'm bringing you today a makeup look with this little baby from Too Faced. It's known as the Grand Hotel Café set, which is one of the many sets that they have out now for the holidays. Yes, I know, it's almost Halloween. We have gone through Halloween, and they release Christmas stuff during October. Why do you do this, stores? Why? Even though I don't mind Lush and Bath & Body Works doing that. But anyways, if you haven't seen any of the videos or anything, Too Faced is pretty famous with their holiday sets, and they have pretty nice stuff. Heck, I even looked on their holiday stuff when I was looking through getting the Power of Love set with Nikki tutorials on their website. And I stumbled upon this, and a lot of people like it on YouTube. This is not the only set that they have. They have one exclusively for Ulta, which is their Merry Macaroons, which I have my eye on. And the Chocolate Shop, which is only at Sephora. They do have little ornaments and other little sets to choose from. And this one, I got it with my little Ulta card. Let's take a look. This set comes with three little palettes that look like little books that you find in a cafe. Ain't that cute? And you have six eyeshadows and a face product. Two of them come with blushes. Another one, and the last one comes with a bronzer. And man, this smells good, because these are scented after different Christmas drinks. This one is eggnog latte. If you see me feeling, I have a little braille label. And it smells like eggnog. Oh my god, that smells good. You know me, I'm a major coffee lover, and this set is perfect for the coffee lover in your life. And I'm gonna swatch a bit. This one is like very warm tone. Like, you can see that right there. This one comes with one of the blushes. Then, of course, you have gingerbread cookie, which looks like that. Which, of course, you have six shadows in the face product. And this one has the bronzer. I tend to use bronzers as eyeshadows. And it smells like gingerbread. Oh my god. And of course, here's a swatch of one of those eyeshadows right here. Some people say some of the shadows are a little weak. But of course, when you swatch, sometimes you don't have the primer. And finally, the one that you will be seeing me use today is Peppermint Mocha. It has a slight pepperminty taste, but this is... Some people say the shadows aren't as pigmented as the other two, but here's a swatch as of one of them as a little sneak peek. This one is one I'm going to be using. It's my... Peppermint mochas are my favorite drink around holiday time, especially when I went to Holiday Matsuri last year. Which, speaking of which, this would be a nice little present for that coffee lover that would be staying with you. Like, you know, your friend comes down for the convention and you don't know what to get them, and want to give them an early Christmas present before they go back home. This one would be perfect for them. And of course, you have the deluxe size of the forever popular Better Than Sex mascara. I took that out because it takes up a lot of room in this thing and causes one of the books to pop out a little bit. So I'll be using that whenever I run out of the Nikki Tutorials purple mascara. Yeah. So anyways, today I am giving you a look with this peppermint mocha one. Sorry, can't stop smelling. Too Faced, you make your palette smell so good. I mean, especially the chocolate bar. I still have mine intact. Not sure if you guys heard about that story about that one kid who ate her aunt's Too Faced chocolate bar. I mean, I keep mine away from my nephews. It's like, kids, it may look like a little chocolate bar, but it's not really. Okay, first up, I am starting with my NYX eyebrow gel. And I'll be using my eyebrow brush. If you're hearing sounds in the background, I'm still out here in Daytona doing a work experience. I love
10 faces.
I love this thing, this little eyebrow gel. Okay, next I'm going to be using my Essence Backstage Eye Primer. I can see why people love this stuff. I may be running out, but I do have the Shadow Insurance Primer from the Nikki Tutorial set. And if anybody has bought anything from the 21 Days of Beauty, I also picked up the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer when it was half off one day, which made me happy. That thing is expensive, and once you see that on sale, buy it during the 21 Days of Beauty. That was a major steal. Even though I did get one of the vials of the eye primer at Sephora once.
10 faces.
One thing I don't like about the vials of primer is that they run out so quickly and everybody uses. Yeah, you only need a pea sized drop, but it's hard to control the consistency of it, in my opinion, that way. So I had to brush this stuff on as much as I can, even though I'm starting to run out, but this thing lasted me an entire month because it has a lot of product to it, which is a good thing. Unlike the Maybelline Master Prime, even though it's one of my favorite, it doesn't have too much product to last me so long. Same with the Elf one. I think NYX also lasts me a long time. I'm gonna try and get more of that one too. Next, I'm gonna be using one of my eyeshadow brushes for setting my under eyes, a concealer brush. There's one of my eyeshadow brushes. The double end So I'm going to take this color right here. I don't know the color names, but as long as you, I would say go on Ulta's website or Too Faced website, they'll tell you the colors of the name. One interesting fact about one of the eyeshadows in one of the other palettes, they named it after the coffee shop and Friends. I didn't know about that until Madison mentioned it. In her dope or nope video on Too Faced. Oh my god, I still smell the mint. It's subtle. I don't like it when most of my stuff is like overpowering. And I like how it's just subtle, not overbearing, that you're like, ugh! Or I tend to hiss like a vampire with garlic or sunlight when it comes to overpowering scents or really bad convention funk. Because my nose is so sensitive with being a blind person. Okay. I'm thinking doing this one in the center over here and running it through my crease. Okay, I'll put that
1-0 faces
where. Okay, keep on grabbing the one meant for setting my under eye concealer brush. Where is it? There you are. Gonna use this top one over here for the brow. It smells. I get addicted too easily to these nice smelling palettes. It's worse with the chocolate bar. And of course, when I was in the store with Gondress, since he was visiting me from Orlando, the lady had me smell, I think it was semi-sweet or was it the bonbons? And I told her I have the first chocolate bar. And I forgot what she told me, like people do love these palettes though. It's tempting to get these things. From Too Faced. All I have to say, they do a really good job Next, I'm going to put on eyeliner, and I'm going to use my Wet n Wild brown one, which to me, the brown eyeliner goes well with these palettes. That's my opinion. If you want to use black eyeliner, go ahead. Go with it. But it's your choice. Been using this eyeliner a lot, but I do have more brown liners. Okay, next, if I can find that cap, oh, there it is. Next, I'm gonna adjust a little bit of everything considered. That's when my eyeshadow goes out of proportion, all thanks to the brushes I tend to use. I remembered when I first started doing the eyeshadow thing, I had shadow all over my face, and I had to have everybody help me adjust it, even though it was, like, sometimes annoying. They kind of get a little upset once where my mom said I can't be wearing makeup when I'm out with my parents because I look like a vampire. Okay, seriously. Okay. Next, for mascara, and guess what I picked up? My VTelescopic by L'Oreal. Somehow L'Oreal and Maybelline make really good mascaras. Also, I need to get another tube of Supersizer by CoverGirl. I do have some by Rimmel. And by Rimmel, and do have my samples from Smashbox, Urban Decay, and of course that deluxe size of the purple one from Pallet MakeUp. Make sure, cause and mascara be clumpy. Okay, next is the face. Oh, silly me, I forgot to put my bangs back with my clip. I forgot that I put it with my Harley Quinn train case. I got another bottle of the post-heat balm by Nvidia. Spray around. Is it me, or does sometimes when you get certain products, it's a little stronger than you bought them before? Because this bottle seems to have a stronger smell to the aftershave part. Mm-hmm. Okay, gonna grab my concealer brush. That same brush. And gonna use my favorite Elme concealer. And go where it needs to go, where no man has gone before. I know, I am somewhat of a Trekkie. Don't mind me. I go crazy nerdy and do the quotes. And in case if anybody's wondering, unfortunately, due to circumstances, we are not doing press for Tampa MegaCon this weekend. I wish we could have made it, but Gondris has to work, and I'm way out here on the East Coast when, yes, I'm kind of sad and can't beat David Tennant, but who knows, maybe Orlando will get him as a guest next year, and we are trying out Orlando again next year. We did have a small interview with the show director from Tampa Bay Mega, which, well, when you look at it, it is somewhat as right there. But we are looking forward towards the holiday Matsuri, since we got press second year in a row. Yes, you'll get videos, and hoping we get some interviews too. We're going to be covering events that they've chosen, which is going to be kind of cool to bring. Because if you have a blog and filled out that form, I suggest doing it. It'll boost up certain views, but I was hoping it goes well. Okay, next is gonna be under my concealer with the CoverGirl Visible Lift Concealer. I found it. Okay. Under eye. Blend that in slightly. And put that back in my pouch. Next, going in with the Clear Complexion Foundation by Pallet. If I could find my little, there it is, the cup where I tend to put it into blend. One, two. I used to do four pumps of it, but I had to make this, I had to stretch this out. And also, not sure if anybody knows this, but if you go a little too much, sometimes you feel that burn sensation. But I know most people do two pumps or go a little excessive. One face, zero faces. I know I was kind of excessive before with 4 pumps. But now I lessen it, and it actually feels a lot better. Just doing 2 pumps and instead of the 4. Blend it with my brush. Get in the cheeks and chin, nose, area underneath the nose. Give it a little bit more to the upper regions of my face. Blend it. Okay, I think I blended enough. Alrighty. Okay, next up is highlighter. And I'm going to be using Electric Slide by ColourPop, which is from their holiday collection last year. I wish Too Faced offered a nice little sample highlighter, a highlight of their candle highlight. The candle glow. Yep, brought out that brush from Real Techniques. Because I use it for highlighter. Where is it? Ah, found it. And this is a really good brush. If you haven't tried ColourPop products before, you should. They're really good. And make sure you close them nice and tight. And next is doing the blush. I think it's called Santa Baby. stand it, baby. Something, something. Do, 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 do. I know, it's kind of awkward doing this the day before Halloween. I mean, 2 days before Halloween. I'm sorry, gotta remember it's due to leap year, it's on a Monday. Because we haven't gone through Halloween yet. Well, not sure. If you're a major Bath and Body Works and Lush fan, or either or, what is your favorite scent of the holidays? Mine from Bath and Body Works are Twisted Peppermint and Vanilla Bean Noel. While from Lush, it's, of course, the forever famous Snow Fairy. I always love around Christmas how they bring out really nice items, especially for cosmetics. Oh, I forgot in both. And I know I have that little tiny brush here somewhere. In this little pouch. There we go. Not sure if anybody has been doing what I do. If not, those little brushes and highlighters and blushes that you buy at stores or counters, those are really good for blending in your blush and highlight into your skin afterwards. Because it gives you a nice little feeling. Usually, someone who used to stay here that used to be a former makeup artist gave me this tip and do it on the edges. But I like to do it all over to give it a nice airbrush look. She used to work in department stores as a makeup artist before she started going blind. Okay, now I'm gonna set my under eyes with Ofra's oil control powder, even though I'm not oily, but I like using this to set my under eyes. Because, you know, living in Florida, it's not easy when you're sweating. That's why a lot of snowbirds do come to Florida and stay here, especially for all the events in theme parks, like the Very Merry Christmas Parade, and I'm not sure what Universal does anymore. I rarely go. I have a feeling they decorate Hogwarts over in Harry Potter to make it look like the festive Christmas stuff that they do in the movies. And next is the final step, my clear complexion powder in light medium. And I use the concealer in this same color. Well, the CoverGirl, I use it in light for my under eyes due to it being lighter than your skin tone from so many people on YouTube. And in my foundation, it's warm. I may have to get another compact in of this powder. powder. I've been using this powder for many, many, many years. I did try out the Smart Shade one, but I like this one more. Because it blends so seamlessly with this brush. Now for lips. Usually I would use the lip item of whatever days I'm using, but
landscape, hope viewfinder, image, double tap and hold to adjust exposure.
Is it still recording?
Characters. Viewfinder. Image. 36 minutes. 1 second.
Okay. It is still working. Sorry if my camera kind of flipped.
36 minutes. 10 seconds.
Right. I know I had a Too Faced lipstick somewhere. Because years ago when I got my chocolate bar palette, I did at a 3 lipstick set. Like a lipstick trio. And I got one of those lipsticks out for this look. Now I'll put my lip balm on.
Small face. Zip. 36 minutes. 45 seconds.
And I know I have that lipstick here somewhere. That's my powder. Oh, found it. Found it. I know they still do this, but they have now a...
One fake. Zip. 37 minutes. 27 seconds.
Okay. This one. These lipsticks are so smooth. I heard they still do the trios that every year, or sometimes. They even have a new one, but with a bigger pouch, because the pouch that they come in, their lipstick size. From when I got it. And there you go, that's my look. Thanks for watching, and check out the links below, especially the ones for my book, because I would love the love and support. And also, stay tuned over on the WordPress side for the convention spotlight on Holiday Matsuri 2016. So, until next time, bye.
One zip viewfinder. One face. 38 minutes. Viewfinder. Viewfinder. Cap V. Viewfinder. 38 minutes. Viewfinder. Viewfinder. 38 minutes. Viewfinder. Stop recording video.